a very warm welcome to you. I'm Hayley Palmer. It's really good to have you here with me on the show this evening, especially as we are joined by X Factor winner Matt Terry. And here is what happened when I caught up with him. Matt Terry, it's great to have you on the show. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you for having me.
Oh, it's such a pleasure. Thank you so much. And obviously, we're sort of coming out of lockdown now, but what have you been up to?
Non-stop Zoom, as we are today.
He's a pro.
I'm a pro. I've got it all down. Yeah, just studio sessions, lots of walks. Great. In the beginning, I did the same as everybody else. I was painting, decorating, making banana bread.
It's got to be done.
Absolutely. Up until recently, just working from home, doing studio sessions on Zoom. Got the full kit now, set up my little mini home studio. I'm good to go.
Yes, he's good to go. Well, it's good to have you here. And we're going to play out the first song on the show, which I'm really excited about. I was working at a radio station at the time, and I remember hearing this song and just instantly feeling good, getting that summery feeling. Now, you teamed up with Enrique Iglesias and Sean Paul. Oh my goodness. How did this come about?
Honestly, it's such a... This is the highlight, I think, of my entire career and life. Personally, professionally, everything. It happens because I grew up in Spain, so I speak fluent Spanish. I moved to the UK when I was 18. But obviously, my parents are British, so that's why my English is so really good, I guess. I actually was working on some Spanish stuff for my album, and I was in Miami at the time, and it was honestly just the right place, right time moment. RCA was my label at the time, and that's also Enrique's label, and he'd released Súbeme la Radio with other artists and in different countries. I think he used CNCO for like Latin America, and then he needed somebody for the UK. Obviously he needed someone to speak Spanish. I was like, yo, that's me. And then I remember I was just in the studio in Miami. I recorded the song. We sent it to him. He's like, yeah, love it. And then that was it. He was like, okay, man, you go and do the promo in the UK. And I'm like, yes, leave it to me. I'll do it all. And that's sort of how it happened. I didn't even know Sean Paul was on it as well. So like when they played, I think my team were trying to keep it a surprise for me. And then they was like, oh, here it is. And I listened to it. And then I hear like Shandibal. I was like, what? Oh my God. It was amazing.
Just awesome. Well, I mean, it was a great success. Top 10 for like 14 weeks, wasn't it? I'm going to get you to actually introduce this, Matt, because I can't pronounce it. My Spanish is rubbish. I took French at school. So we're going to let you introduce it, Matt. Take it away. Yes.
Okay. Coming up is Súbeme la Radio. Hi guys, it's Matt Terry, and you can check out my cover of Positions by Ariana Grande.
Don't do
else, of course, remember you from X Factor from 2016. Now, you won the show. What was that experience like for you? Is it a complete blur, or do you just look back and go, actually, they were really fond, happy memories? How is it for you?
Yeah, I think everybody always asks me this, because you always hear the horror stories, especially everyone's so aware now of mental health and the aftermath of a reality TV show. But I do have to say, although, yeah, of course, I went through all of that, my time on the show was great. Like, I had the best time. I learned so much. I met some really cool people. I did some amazing things. And I feel like I really challenged myself and I grew with the show. I think that's what helped me.
I was going to say, the show was really behind you, I felt.
Yeah, for sure, definitely. I think I just grew with it, and that's the trick, you know. It's something that you can't plan, or it's not a tactic or whatever. It just has to happen, you know. Like, if you go in super strong, by the end, you know, what more can you give? But I just naturally progressed with the show. Like, I gave it my all every time, but each time I got better and better, and that's the formula. I think that's what, you know, I just soaked everything in, from the vocal coaches to Nicole to other contestants.
I was going to touch on that. Yeah, because you had Nicole as your mentor, and she's super positive and super strong, isn't she?
Absolutely.
That must have really helped you.
Definitely. I just used to go into her room and say, there's no other option. Like, I have to win. Like, I can't accept anything else. And in my mind, it's just that, like, I'm a proper, like, power of the mind person. Like, I'm well into manifesting, well into positivity, well into all that. And that's what I say got me through it. Like, my brain, I know I have a talent.
Yeah, it's a mindset.
But yeah, my brain was the main force, I guess.
And that moment when you actually won, because I have to say, I was watching it on YouTube earlier, and you just sort of like fell to the floor.
You know what? It's just...
it's a shock.
I just couldn't believe it, because, oh well, I don't know if I've ever told anyone this, but before the announcement, me and Sarah were sat like backstage on a crate, just sat there, just holding each other's hand, like, look, we're both winners no matter what. Like, we love each other. We're proper good mates. And, you know, in my heart, I was like, oh, come on now, I've come this far. But my in-ears, so when Christmas came around, my track, the backing track, started playing in my ears by accident, but it was in Sarah's key. So I thought I thought in my head, I was like,
That's
the winner's track.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's not mine. It's not my key. And then I was just like, so I remember just standing, we were being like pushed up to the behind the doors. I've got Nicole on my right, holding my hand, Sharon on my left, and then Sarah on the end. And that's why I was so shocked, because I was just like, oh, I don't know if I can swear, sorry. But I was just like, mate, I don't know. I really, Matt. sorry, I keep swearing, but
it's okay, Matt. It's a family show, but we'll let you off.
Thank you. yeah, and then that's when it was. It felt like forever. Honestly, I could have killed him. I could have killed Dermot. It was so long.
I could imagine, because it is for us at home. I mean, I want to go and put the kettle on and make a cup of tea and come back,
amen.
And it's still going.
Oh, if I could have done that, I would have.
No, just brilliant. And I mean, your winner single, When Christmas Comes Around, which was a charity single. Now, this was written by Mr. Ed Sheeran.
Yes.
Wow.
I know.
Just wow.
I'm just like, I just think, like, you know, I can only speak about my journey, you see? Like, I've had the opportunity to work with, you know, these people, like, from the start, which was amazing. Like you say, it's just when you just now, even just sitting down, like, I've just become so, not that I ever wasn't, but I just feel so normal. And so, like, I just walk to the shop, like, I go to Sainsbury's, like, I'm doing the same as everyone else. And, like, I'm just the normal person. And then when you tell me your debut single was written by Ed Sheeran and you've collaborated with Enrique and Sean Paul, then I'm like, oh, damn, I did that. It's like, yes, I
oh,
did
we
that.
Love you even more for that, Matt. Oh, brilliant. Well, we're going to play out the single right now. Enjoy this, and we'll see you after.
Winter days turn to grey, put the headlights on, snow and rain wiped away.
Hi guys, it's Matt Terry. Check out my cover of Fallin' by Harry Styles.
I'm in my bed and you're not here, and there's no one to blame but the drink in my wandering hands. Forget what I said, it's not what I meant, and I can't take it back. I can't unpack the baggage you left. What am I now? What am I now? What if I'm so cafe, and it kills me 'cause I know we've run out of things we can say. What am I now? What am I now? What if I'm someone I don't want around? I'm falling again, I'm falling again, I'm falling. What if I'm
a little bit, because when you went on to X Factor, I thought they said that you were a waiter in Carluccio's. Mm-hmm. I've missed that place. But actually, you did train at a performing arts college. It was a D&B Academy. I've heard of that, yeah. Which is a great college. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, you had had some professional training, hadn't you?
Yes, definitely. So what happened was I lived in Spain and I really wanted to sing for a career. My singing teacher said, you have to be in London or, you know, go move. You know, you got to go. From I lived in a tiny little town where there wasn't much. And so I've gone home, Mum, I need to move to London. And then she was like, we've looked up, you know, it was more like musical theatre was like the safest. My mum kind of wanted, she supported me, but was like, let's find something that's a bit more, you know. So I was like, great. And I'd always sang, always danced, always, you know, acted around as a kid my whole life. And yeah, so I auditioned for a college and obviously my parents didn't really have much money. So I had to get the scholarship, otherwise it wasn't going to happen. But luckily I got the scholarship and That was it. My whole family sold the house and we all moved over so I could go to... Yeah, it's mad. I owe it to them. So did that, moved over here, did 3 years, completed that, booked myself an agent. But for 2 years, I was auditioning for everything. Book of Mormon, Kinky Boots, Thrill Alive.
All my favourites.
Yeah, yeah. All of those. And just got so close every time. I was just, you know... It was me or someone else, or I don't know. The feedback would always be, he's too young. I was 20 years old.
Yeah.
And I'd be like, fair enough. So in the meantime, for 2 years, that's where Carluccio's came in. I had to stay in London. Yeah, I had to pay my rent. So I was a waiter there for 2 years. And then I ended up going on X Factor.
Wow, I was going to say, because when was that point you knew that you could really sing? Because I've always known, Matt, that I'm a terrible singer, but you must know, well, actually, you know what, I'm quite good. Like, I could make this, you know, be my career.
Yeah. To be honest, like, my whole life, I remember just a really, I must have been about six and I was singing a Christina Aguilera song on the karaoke or something. And it was just at home and my mum was cooking and then she sort of came into the, like, stuck her head round the corner into the front room, like, like, she was like, whoa. Aww. And that's sort of when then, and then from then on, like, everyone, I was so into music. I loved, like, Bruno Mars. I loved Craig David, was like my guy. Like, that's what my, me and my dad always listens to his albums and all that, and I always loved sort of that R&B Motown music. We listened to, like, the Drifters, Barry White, all those people. Everyone my whole life was like, oh yeah, Matt can sing, and I never really thought anything of it. And then it wasn't until I think I turned 15, 16, and I was like, all right, let me take some lessons. And then I went to the lesson, she was like, oh my god, this is your life, you need to do this. And I was like, okay, cool. So I guess 16.
Yes. Yeah. Love that. Well, what a great success it all turned out to be. So we'll be talking about that in a little bit. Now we're going to go into your next song, Sucker For You. Now, where did the idea behind this song come from, Matt?
At the time, it was just, you know, when you break up with somebody and you're basically acting like a mug and just you do anything to get them back. Even, you know, you lose all of your... We all go through it. We've all been there.
We've all been there.
Yeah, you lose all of your care for yourself and your love for yourself and you just do anything to get this person back. So it's all about just being a bit of a mug and a bit of a loser trying to win back somebody that you was once with. So that's sort of where it came from. I was in Sweden at the time and I was there for like 3 days and I wrote 3 songs and Sucker For You was one of them.
Well, it was shot in Miami, though, wasn't it?
It was. Yeah, it was shot in Miami. Wow, you're bringing super back jealous. All the feels. You're making me
I am, Matt. Super I nostalgic. Am. We're going to play out the video. It's a fantastic video. Enjoy this. And we will see you in just a couple of minutes.
Shut me out, but pull me close. Kind of loving it, give me
up. Well, we've got some questions from some of our lovely viewers. Sean would like to know, well, she said that she saw you in Madagascar, the musical. Mm-hmm. And are there any other musicals that you would like to go into in the future?
Oh, God. Yeah, loads, definitely. I think right now, to be completely honest, the core focus is music. I've just been working nonstop on new music, a completely new sound, a completely new... me just found myself really in this moment of, you know, okay, everything's sort of click place, I get it, I understand everything, this is who I am, kind of thing. But I love theatre as well, so I absolutely will in the future. I don't know what, I don't know when.
Watch this space.
I definitely will, so keep looking out
thank
for
you.
It.
We'll watch that space, Sean. And Kelly would like to know, what is your favourite thing that you would like to do when you get out of lockdown fully? Is there something you've really missed? The gym, Nando's?
Yeah. Oh my gosh, both of those things. Wow.
There we go. Wow. I was just thinking for myself.
No, that is me. Yeah, I know. I've been back to the gym since Monday, just gone on the top when it reopened. So... I've been enjoying that, just getting out the house, something to do. You know what I can't wait for? I just can't wait to go to the cinema with a handful of friends. And I've been sat on my ass all day watching telly, mostly anyway, but the experience and the smell of the popcorn and the giant like drink, and then on the way out go and stop off at Nando's, and that's all I want, and a bit of sushi because I love sushi, but yeah, that's it.
Honestly, I'm literally dreaming about that right now. You're right. When you go to the cinema, the drinks are too big, aren't they?
Like, I've never thought about that. Who's going to drink
that? Why are they so big? Yeah. I don't know. I really don't know. At least in Nando's, you can just kind of go and refill it at your leisure.
Yeah.
So I'm with you on that.
I can't wait.
We're gonna play out your song "Try." Now Montana, I spotted her from Love Island in the video to this.
Yes. Yeah.
Love that.
Definitely.
What was the story behind this?
Nothing. We just sort of really clicked. We met at events a couple of times and got on really well. And I was in the middle of doing it all. And I was like, I know she liked, just from speaking to her, I knew that she liked to do a bit of acting here and there. So I thought, YOLO. I was like, do you want to come be on our music video? She was like, hell yeah, let's do it. And we did.
Yeah, no, it's fantastic. It's a great video. We're going to check that out. And we'll see you after.
On your shoulders, ain't nobody could have warned you.
I want to talk about things moving forward. I did notice on your Twitter that you've got West End Live Lounge coming up on Monday, the 14th of the June. Tell us a little bit more about that.
Yeah, so I recently bought a musical theatre agent on board of my team. I wanted to do it authentically, just because I've trained in theatre and I know, you know, I want to do it all as a musical theatre performer would. I don't want to just feel like I'm swanning in as, you know, a name, whatever that means. And
yeah, because it's almost harder, isn't it? Because when you've come out of X Factor, it's definitely. Like people are like, oh, well, you know, you should be at this standard or whatever. But it's almost like you've got to prove yourself even more, isn't it?
Definitely. And more just because I know that so much. I know that I've auditioned for everything. I've lived the life of a performer. You know, throwing off my apron, running down to the train station. I'm making it sound really dramatic. Getting changed in the toilet,
like the drama.
Running to my audition, getting cut, said no, and then running back to my shift. No. Yeah, I've lived that, and I just wanted to... I have so much respect for the industry, so that's why I've got a genuine musical theatre agent on board. I've recently had new headshots. I forgot the question. What did you ask me?
You can just talk about what you want, Matt.
Okay, great. Cool, yeah.
We're talking about West End Live Lounge.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Wow. So that's sort of where that's come in. So my agent, Will, his company's called Orlando Gray. And, yeah, the guys there asked if I would like to take part in the West End Live Lounge. And, of course, I want everything to get back up and running. So anywhere I can support, I will. So there's some great other actors and singers, performers, all singing songs that are from the greats. And it will be a really lovely evening just to sort of, let's get everybody bums on seats.
Woo, let's do it. Well, we're going to put a link on the screen below of how you can get your ticket. And obviously, I know you've been in the studio. You've been writing for yourself and writing for others as well, haven't you?
Yes, I have. Just non-stop, really. I'd say I've probably got 2 albums worth, if not more, for myself. And for others, it's been really cool. I kind of love to put myself in like the zone of, you know, whoever it may be. Like I had the opportunity to write for Kalani and Cardi B a couple of months ago, and I was like, whoa. So there I was, like, I love Kalani anyway, she's like my artist of lockdown, her new album. I've just sort of really been just, it's been nice to write from a different perspective than that's not your own, and it's challenging and I like it.
Yes. Well, keep us posted here on the show because we look forward to seeing the updates. But we're going to go into your next song, The Thing About Love, which is about losing love, which I think is a song that most people can sort of relate to.
Definitely. Again, I wrote this, so similar vibe to like Sucker For You. This is just about sometimes you can absolutely find the right person and fall in love with them and they just don't want you back, which kind of sucks.
We've all been there.
We've all been there.
Again.
Yeah, definitely. I think it's just something that everyone can relate to. It's so strange, like looking back, listening to my my first album, I just feel so, like, I'm so proud of it, but I feel like what's to come is like who I truly, really am. And I've kind of figured it all out now. It's sort of, this first album was me, like, you know, trying different, I don't know, genres, melodies, experiences, write about this, about that. Whereas, yeah, so, yeah, forgive me, when I hear it now, I'm just like, oh, but I think that's the same really? As...
Yeah, it's always the way, isn't it, when you look back on things?
Definitely.
I mean, when I look back on my work, I go, exactly. Oh, dear, that's cringy. Yeah,
exactly.
It's, you know... You've come a long way, but we like it, so we want to play it, and we will enjoy it. See you after.
Found the letter that you wrote. Was in the pocket of my...
We're going to go into a last song. I actually saw this on your Twitter. It's POV by Ariana Grande, your cover, and you sing it with just the most amazing vocal. So I thought we should play it out on the show, if that's okay with you, Matt.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm happy with that.
Yeah. Okay, we're going to play that. But thank you so much. It's been so lovely to not only hear your journey, like you said, take a look about like where you came from to where you are now. We're loving your new stuff. So do keep us posted here on the show, won't you?
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you so much for having me.
Yeah.
And your support means everything. So
yeah, and it was great to talk about Nando's as well, because
the toilets,
great talk.
The music in the toilets.
We love the toilets. We love the music in the toilets. Yes.
Yeah. The experience.
Just brilliant. But thank you so much. It has been such an honour and pleasure to have you here on the show. Thank you. It's Matt Terry, everyone.
Thank you.
Huge thank you, Matt Terry. What a brilliant guest on tonight's show. And thank you to you at home for tuning in and supporting the show. It really is very much appreciated. Thank you. Now, I will see you same time, same place next week. I'm going to leave you with that last song, Matt's cover of Ariana Grande, POV. Enjoy, and I'll see you then.
It's like you got superpowers. Turn my minutes into hours. You got more than 2020, babe. Might have glass the way you see through me. You know me better than I do. Can't seem to keep nothing from you. I attach myself from the outside. Pie me with my ego and my pride. I wanna love me. Ooh, the way that you love. Keep you waiting. Oh, my baggage fading, safer.